Well, hello, everybody. This is Caroline at Create Your Future. How's everyone today? All right, so I am here, a coach available for one-on-one coaching. If you need any help, you can find all the information in the box below. We are still giving away our free course on how to pinpoint your blocks and manifest anything fast. It's free. You can sign up. Again, the description in the box below. All right, guys, today I am going to continue what I told you 2 weeks ago, go answering subscribers' questions. So, first questions: how do your thoughts make it show up in reality? So, how do our thoughts show up in reality? How does this work? Okay, that's a basic question, and I'll be happy to answer. So, how does it work? We believe here in this channel that our reality is a reflection, it's a mirror image of our consciousness. Consciousness being both the conscious mind and the subconscious mind combined, all right? So whatever it is that you believe, whether you're aware of it or unaware, unconsciously believe, will be projected into your reality, and there it is for you to experience. That's why sometimes people say, well, if everything comes from us and it's being projected in our 3D reality, why do we have unpleasant circumstances? Why do we go through circumstances, experiences that are painful, that are atrocious at times, it's traumatizing? Why would we do this if it comes from us? If we, you know, make it all up in our mind, why would we even create something that horrible? Well, that's because we create we constantly create with our thoughts, with our beliefs, with our assumptions, and it's being pushed out in the, you know, in the 3D reality for us to experience. But most of the time, when we are not aware and conscious of the stories that we are telling ourselves, of the thoughts we are thinking, we start believing certain things, or we always have believed certain things growing up, and these things are being pushed out. So, you know, do you purposely create damaging situations? Probably not. However, it is in your energy field. It is in your consciousness. Somehow, somewhere, you know, a belief that you have. What could it be? I was talking to a client last night, so that would be a perfect example. She said, we've been working together for quite a while, and that's a regular client. And she had a lot of, you know, ups and downs, which is absolutely normal in the journey. So that's why I always tell you to don't beat yourself up. Don't beat yourself up if you've been going, you know, upwards, in the sense that you're starting to see movement, you're starting to manifest things that you like, and that then suddenly it feels like everything is collapsing or you're going backwards. It's okay. It occurs quite often. Doesn't have to occur, but I see this all the time. I see it in my life as well. So you don't beat yourself up. You just go back to your disciplined work of choosing thoughts that support your end scene, that support what it is that you want to manifest. So the girl I was talking to was trying to manifest a specific person, and she had gone through a lot of disappointment, a lot of heartache, a lot of tears, and she really felt for a long time that this specific person had no desire for her, that he didn't care, that he had his own life and she was not part of it. And as a matter of fact, every time he was doing something, an event, a party, she was not invited. So she felt extremely rejected. So we worked on overcoming all this, rebuilding a new story. We did a lot of rampages together, during sessions. That's something that she really much enjoys doing. And there was little movement at first, then, you know, the momentum picked up and it got more and more and more, to the point where now she sleeps over his house several times a week. They are, you know, building this relationship. And what happened was that as they were getting closer, she found herself in a position where she was unable to handle it. She did not know why. She did want to be able to handle it, but she did not know why she couldn't. And there was, you know, some freak out moments, to say the least, where it even, you know, the freak out moment were translated into physical pain. She had horrible anxiety. She had stomach pain. Her body was taking a toll on this. So as she was getting closer to her goal, which was the relationship with that SP, her body was reacting and she was in pain. And her reaction was to flee the scene, like leave his house, go back home and just, you know, be alone and deal with the panic moment, panic, cry, actually really nothing fun. And it was really, really hard. So we talked about it and, you know, going back, uncovering the fact that deep down, her true belief is that she's not lovable. She's not lovable because she believes that growing up, the people who were caring for her, the people who were raising her, the people who were around her did not love her. So there was, you know, a lot of different events that made her feel that way. Whether it's true or not, that's a different story. But that's how she felt. And this is the belief that then became created. So it's really important to understand also that a lot of our beliefs, I don't know if all of them, but our beliefs, you know, come from feelings that we have and then conclusions that we draw upon those feelings, and then we just believe them. So did she consciously believe that she was not lovable? Maybe sometimes, but not all the time. And certainly not in a situation with this boyfriend, because we've been working for so long to, you know, to create the reality of her being in a relationship with him. And now he was finally showing her love and attention and a lot of, you know, sweet gestures towards her. So what happened is that the dominant unconscious belief was still that she was not lovable. And so when somebody came to her and started loving her, there was this initial reaction to that she did not control, right? So she pushed him away. And then she was desperate that she pushed him away. That's not what she wanted, of course. So, you know, now we're working on reconciling all this, healing this very old past belief in order to not have it anymore and to create a new one. But creating a new belief in this case is linked to a feeling, right? That deep feeling that she felt over and over growing up from being rejected by the people who were supposed to protect her and love her and care for her. So to go back to the question, how do our thoughts make it show up in reality? It's a combination of our beliefs, assumptions, and our thoughts that are both conscious and unconscious. And they exist within our consciousness, which is who we are, and they are reflected just like you would see your reflection in the mirror, right? So whatever you look at in the mirror and whatever you're doing in front of the mirror is what you see, right? If you raise your right hand, the mirror is going to reflect the same. So it's exactly the same process with our thoughts. Our thoughts, beliefs, assumptions. They are in our consciousness and they are projected in our 3D reality. Therefore, whatever you like, whatever you want, and that whatever you like in your 3D reality, and which is also what you want to have and continue to have, you know, you kind of milk this, you milk that, whatever feeling you have attached to whatever you see that you know you enjoy, that you have already achieved, that you are experiencing. And that feeling, you can then recreate it artificially when there is something in your 3D reality that you don't like, but you want to change and you don't know how to change. So you think about the scenario that you want, and then you attach to it that feeling that you had for the other thing that you liked, you know, and you artificially like kind of put it, you know, like it's like a copy and paste of the feeling on the new scenario or the new experience or the people you want, you know, the certain type of relationship you want to have in your reality. And then from there, you recreate it. So let's say, to go back, for instance, with the SP. Some people would say, well, okay, you don't like the situation. You don't like that, okay, SP is pushing you away or ghosting you, whatever. And you want to change that. You want to be in a relationship with SP. So yes, you can maybe just say the affirmations that, you know, SP is madly in love with me and we are in this incredible, loving, exciting, committed relationship. You can say those affirmations and repeat them until they become a belief, and then you see them being pushed out. That's one thing. However, when it's deep rooted, just like with the example I give you with my client, where she could not control her reactions and the very old buried, almost unconscious belief of her not being lovable still remains in her consciousness dominantly. So when that is the case, we need to dig a little more, right? We need to go through the steps of those rejection moments throughout life and then kind of deal with them and then create the affirmations. The reason why in my coaching I do that, I do go back and I'd like to explain the steps, is because a very deep rooted belief that is not conscious is usually dominant. And it means that even if you repeat your affirmations, the dominant one will take over. And then you'll be like, well, I've been saying my affirmations, I've been scripting, and I still see in my 3D reality the unwanted version of the relationship. So that's why I tackle it that way in my coaching. But I'm not saying that you can't just do affirmations and it happens. The less attached you are to the outcome, you know, the less you need to say your affirmation. So you may say something only once, just once, one affirmation, but really have zero attachment to it. Be like, yeah, it doesn't, you know, you don't care. You say it, but you actually don't care. Well, then that will show up in your reality instantly, you know? So it really depends also on the level of resistance you have, and the level of resistance that you have goes with the level, it's the attachment, how the intensity of the attachment you have to the outcome. So, you know, we looked at all those different aspects, but again, to answer that question, how do our thoughts make it show up in reality? Our thoughts are being mirrored. from our consciousness. Everything in our consciousness is being mirrored. Everything you believe is being mirrored in your 3D reality. So if you don't like it, you change those beliefs, assumptions, and thoughts. And if you're still having trouble not seeing what you want in your 3D reality, then we look a little deeper. We look at what could be the unconscious belief. All right, so, it's already 15 minutes. I'm gonna end here with just one question for today. And in the next video, I will talk about more, I will answer more questions. I intend that today's video helped, and I know that all of you can focus, can overcome any unconscious beliefs, and enjoy absolutely what it is that you want in this 3D reality. And you know, when I say that, just go big, go big. Don't just think about the little next step. Think like 10 steps ahead. What's gonna happen if, you know, assume that you already have this, this, and that, and then how do you live your life? And how is it like when you are there? How amazing is it? And then affirm over this, repeat your affirmations, and go ahead, you know, go with the scripting, whatever. You saturate your mind with this new story. That's what it is. Alrighty. So I still have 50% off on all the hypnosis tracks, the bundles as well. The coupon code is SAVE50, SAVE50. If you order any on our website, Create Your Future. And then all the affirmation tracks, Rampages, Thought Transmission track, they all go for $25. I have a whole bunch of title. They are all listed in the website, all right? Titles as I'm a Catch, My SP Moves Mountains for Me, My SP Loves Me, Rampages about health, money, body image, pregnancy, being engaged, getting married, getting an apology, all that good stuff. All right, guys, have a wonderful week, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye-bye.